day for the Laker organization and for that young man right there, Anthony Davis, talking to general manager Rob Pelinka, head coach Frank Vogel. They will join him right now at the introductory press conference. We take you live to
Good morning, everybody. So today is really a history-shifting day for the Los Angeles Lakers. And I think anytime you have a landmark event where you have an opportunity to introduce the most dominant young basketball player in the world as a member of a Los Angeles Lakers, you have a lot of people to thank as part of the journey in getting here. So I just wanted to start today really with the gratitude and thanking the people behind this, starting with Jeannie Buss, our leader. She is the strongest and most wise leader that I've been around in my life, and we're just so grateful for her and her conviction to lead to a transaction like this. I want to thank Tim Harris for just the integrity he brings to always thinking about the Lakers brand and making sure we do things to uphold that integrity. I'd also like to thank, got a list of people here, so I want to
Anthony, Jim Hill from CBS2 and KKL9. First of all, congratulations and good luck. Seems like we've been talking about you coming here for months and months now. How relieved are you that it is finally over? And what was the most difficult part of this process for you?
Thank you. I think the most difficult part for me was just not knowing, the unknown. You know, it was whether, I get traded or whether, I go back to New Orleans. So I think the unknown was just the most difficult for me. And then when it was announced that I was being traded. I don't say it was a sign of relief. It was just, something that, that I've thought about for a long time. Obviously, it was tough for me to, leave a city that I've been playing for 7 years. But I think it was, best for me, and it was my time. But when I found out I was getting traded to the Lakers, I realized it was an unbelievable opportunity for me. To be here with a wonderful organization and then get to play alongside, LeBron and obviously now the players that we have now. But back then, before, it was really just LeBron here. And so, to get the opportunity to do that, and come here and play for an organization that's all about winning, winning championships, and that's the only goal. I think that was the biggest thing for me, just the relief there of not, not knowing the unknown anymore and knowing where I was going to be next season.
Hey, Anthony, Mike Trudell with the Lakers and Spectrum. Just wondered how you think that playing alongside LeBron on offense and defense is going to impact your game, just having somebody that's along that same level of skill. And then I also wondered, Coach Vogel, if you could address that as well.
The things he do on the floor, pretty amazing. You see it on TV and, when you're a fan of the game, you watch it a lot. Mm-hmm. And I never really had a chance to experience, playing alongside him. 2012 Olympics, I didn't play as much. I was like the towel guy, just waving towel. We had a little bit of time doing All-Star games, but to get a full season and to see the things that he's able to do, pass, shoot, talks well defensively, he's a great leader. So I'm excited to, get a lot of that, this season and just go from there.
Yeah, and I would say that if you were the towel guy, they were misusing you. I don't care how old you were.
right. I was 18 then,
In terms of the two of them complementing each other, both are guys that are going to command double teams in any action that you put them in. They're going to draw a lot of attention. So to have a second star to be the counterpunch to each other is really just going to, you know, have the two of them complement each other.
Anthony, you've been seen in cameras, kind of talking with LeBron over the last couple months, and gone to dinner with him. And I was just kind of curious, over the last few months, how has that relationship evolved? And was there any sort of words or advice that kind of carried you through the last couple months where you had a lot of uncertainty from him?
A lot of people before the trade happened, you know, speculated that I was coming to the Lakers just because we had dinner. Me and LeBron are close friends, you know. And a lot of people and players in the league are really close with each other off the court. And obviously, if I live here in the summer and, you know, he's available, you know, we players tend to go to dinner. And so it was a lot of speculation there. But when it happened, you know, obviously we were both excited. And, you know, we haven't really talked much about, you know, the team as much. But I know, you know, it's definitely going to get talked about and try to do whatever we can possible to make this team, you know, a championship team next season. Well, this season.
Hey, Anthony. Dave McMenamin, ESPN. With all the moves that have happened since you've been traded to the Lakers, you know, it seems like the league is in an arms race. How do you stack up your team against what everything's happening in the league right now?
It's going to be fun. It's going to be fun for sure. You know, I'm excited about it. I think the league has grown. I think it's better. All the players, you know, teaming up and kind of spreading that talent throughout the league. It's going to be a fun season. I like our roster. I like, you know, every player that we have, you know, from 1 through 15, or 14, 1 through 14. So I'm excited about it, and, you know, I'll put our roster up against anybody. I feel like that, you know, in a seven-game series that we'll come out victorious.
Yeah, Anthony, Bill Plaschke, Los Angeles Times. How are you seeing a long-term commitment to this club? Are you prepared to make a long-term commitment here? How do you view your time here and your what is your purpose?
I haven't had much time here, to be honest. But honestly, I'm focused on the season. When I got traded here, my goal is to bring a championship here, you know, with the team that we have. And, you know, when that time comes around next year, then you can ask me that question and we revisit it. But right now, you know, my focus is on this year and trying to figure out how I can help this team and, you know, help this organization become a championship team.
Brad Turner, LA Times. Rob, I was just wondering, when you guys were not able to get a deal done back in February, how difficult or challenging was it for you, the organization, to stay the course and not give up on trying to make this trade?
It's a great question, Brad. I think, again, it kind of goes back to the people involved. I think, you know, Gail Benson was involved, and we appreciate that she just kept an open mind to do what was best for both transactions, for both the best transaction for both organizations.
And there is Anthony Davis going to hold up that jersey. As he mentioned, he kind of had to pick a number, Brez, and there it is, yeah. Number 3.
Yeah, the NBA's got rules. They don't like you to switch jerseys right before they start printing new ones for
next
the upcoming
year.
Season. Next year, though, he can get it done. I thought there were some pretty good moments here. Rob Pelinka starting it off by saying it's a history-shifting type of acquisition for the Lakers. AD eventually saying, when he was asked, what does he think of the roster? He said, I'll put our roster up against anybody. I feel like in a seven-game series, we'd come out victorious. So AD very, very excited about being a Laker and about his new teammates, including playing with LeBron. He said, I'm excited to see a lot of him.
Anthony Davis officially introduced as a member of the Purple and Gold. We'll have more reaction coming up next.
Miss a game, you know, you can play through the other one a lot more. And, you know, you're just going to have great depth, and it's going to allow us to win a lot of basketball games.
I got to ask you, because we've had a chance to catch up with some of the latest signees over the last couple of days. You guys were asked about the roster a little bit. When it comes to guys like DeMarcus Cousins, Avery Bradley, who shed 40 pounds, the